In this video, I'll give a slightly different way of thinking about the dimension. When I introduced the self-similarity dimension, the picture was that we had an object and we were trying to figure out the dimension by looking at how many small copies fit in a big copy. In this video, I'll take a slightly different perspective. We'll imagine that we already know an object's dimension, and then we can use that to predict what happens to that object when we scale it up or down. I'll start by looking at some simple geometric objects with integer dimension. So let's think about what happens to shapes if we scale them up. I'll explain what I mean by that in just a sec. So here are three shapes that I drew, not very well, but I made it myself. So here's a line that's one-dimensional. Here's a square that's two-dimensional. And here's a cube that's three-dimensional. So what would happen if I took these shapes and doubled them in size? And I did that by going downstairs in my office building and making a photocopy of this drawing and asking the machine to make it twice as large. So this gets doubled, this is doubled, this length is doubled, and so on. And so the question is, what would happen to the total, say, mass or size of these shapes? Okay, so if I have a line and I double it, well, this line is now twice as big as before. If this was, say it would use twice as much ink, it would, if this was a piece of metal, this would be weigh twice as much. Let's see. So if this, say, imagine was a piece of carpet and I doubled it, this carpet is now four times as big. If this has side one, this has side two, two times two is four. So an area of one goes to an area of four. And this is basically the same sort of calculation we did, same sort of thinking we did when we calculated the self-similarity dimension. Number of small copies equals magnification factor to the D. So for the line, we have, when we magnify it, so we double it, 2 to the d, sorry, let's see. For the line, 2 to the 1 is 2. So if we double, the magnification factor now is 2, we have twice as much line, twice as many small lines as we did before. For the square, it's 4. So now I'm thinking not so much, or not only number of small copies, but maybe something like the overall mass, the amount of material, if this is a square carpet or something, the amount of material in the carpet. And then for the cube is three-dimensional. If we have this cube, I'm picturing a solid cube here, and then we have a magic machine that doubles the size of the solid cube, well, it would weigh 8 times as much. If this is length 1, this cube has a volume of 1, this is length 2, 2 times 2 times 2 would give me 8. You can also picture that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of these cubes fit in here. So for a cube, we would have 2 cubed equals 8. So if you put a line, a square, a cube in the copy machine and ask how much bigger they are, how much more massive they are, that copy machine does different things, 2, 4, and 8. Again, I'm imagining a copy machine that works on volumes as well. So maybe this is some sort of crazy 3D printer or photocopier. All right. So now, let's think about a different shape. So this is the Koch curve. So here's a small Koch curve. And then I did the same thing. I put it in the photocopy machine. And I said, all right, make it twice as big. So now the question is, if I go from this to this, how much bigger is this? Bigger measured in terms of maybe the total amount of ink I would need to make this. Or if I was building a sculpture, how much heavier would this be than that one? And you might think, oh, well, it's a line, so it would just be twice as big. But it doesn't have a dimension of 1. It's actually not a line. It's a fractal. It's in between dimension 1 and 2. So the dimension of the Koch curve, let's finish this out. Koch curve was about 1.262. So how much bigger is the twice as large Koch curve? Well, let's see. I'm going to need to take 2 and raise it to the 1.262. And I get 2.399. Let's call it around 2.4. So a dimension between 1 and 2, a doubling behavior between lines and squares. So this is maybe a less sort of obviously geometric way to think about dimension. It's really the same as a self-similarity dimension before. It's just a different, slightly different perspective. But it's another way to think about what these numbers mean. If something that's 1.26 dimensional seems too far out or strange, maybe a more down-to-earth way is just to think about what happens when you double the size of a shape. Some shapes, when you double the size, they double. Some, you double it, they go up by 2 to the 2, 4. Sometimes they go up by 8. And here's a shape that the behavior is 2 to the 1.262. So that's another way of thinking about dimension. It tells us how the overall size or mass or quantity of a shape changes if we scale it up or down.